Hi students, welcome to Easy Chemistry by Pathan, and today we are going to discuss another important concept in isomerism, that is cis and trans isomers properties. In last video, video number 5, I explained cis and trans isomerism, that is in geometrical isomerism. Now, difference between cis and trans isomers. So both are geometrical isomers only, but their physical and chemical properties we have to discuss. I recall what is cis and trans. Cis, same atoms are groups, same atoms are groups in same plane, that is cis. And what is a trans? Trans nothing but same atoms are groups are in opposite plane. Same groups, same side, cis. Same groups are atoms, opposite side, trans. This we learned already. Now I am comparing cis isomers and trans isomers in detail. Very important for competitives. Cis isomers and trans isomers. Trans isomers. I am taking one property and comparing with the cis and trans. How cis isomers will behave and how trans isomers will behave with examples, their physical and chemical properties. So property 1 I am taking here, dipole moment. So how dipole moment in cis and trans isomers? You know very well, dipole moment due to polarity it rises. Dipole moment nu equal to q into d. Cis isomers dipole moment because of polar. Here I am taking no example. C double bond C, and here I am taking two groups and here two groups. Look, I am taking here chlorine and here chlorine, and in the next plane I am taking hydrogen. Now dichloroethene, am I right? Same atoms or same groups in same plane, that's why this is cis isomer. And here I am taking, now it is C double bond C. Now chlorine atoms are in opposite plane. Chlorine atoms are in opposite plane, means opposite direction. Now here chlorine, hydrogen. This is trans. We learn. Now here dipole moment we have to discuss. Dipole moment of polar groups. See, this is polar groups. This is more electronegative. This is less electronegative. Del minus, del plus. So polarity is there here. So dipole moment of polar group, here additive. Dipole moment, that is dipole moment of polar group. Dipole moment of polar group, that is polar groups have additive effect, have additive effect. Due to this additive effect, dipole moment is more. And here you go for dipole moment of polar groups have opposing effect. See here now, this is now chlorine, more electronegative. Generally we have to show less electronegative to more electronegative. So dipole moment working in this manner, here also working in this manner, means both are in same plane. That is we are calling additive, means adding. And look here now, it is in this direction and here in this direction. These are opposite in direction, means opposing effect. Where opposite in direction, dipole moment nu equal to zero. Dipole moment equal to zero. Here adding now, that's why dipole moment not equal to zero. Dipole moment is not equal to zero. So cis isomers have additive effect, thus high dipole moment. These are having high dipole moment. This is low dipole moment when compare each other. Because here adding, here opposing. That is about dipole moment. Go for another property I am taking here. Dipole moment completed. The property 2. Another physical property I am going to discuss. What is the physical property we have to discuss? Means melting point. Very important property of cis and trans isomers. Melting point. See here, I am taking an example to show the melting point. C double bond C and four groups, two should be same. And here this time I am taking bromine, and here also bromine, same plane. And remaining atoms I am taking hydrogens, dibromo ethane. And here you go for that now. C double bond C and four groups. Bromine we have to take now opposite in direction, because trans, this is Br, hydrogen. So this is cis and this is trans. Now we have to compare the property melting point, means cis and trans isomers melting point. Cis isomers always has lower melting point. Remember, cis isomers are always low melting point than trans. So trans are high melting point. Why melting point of cis isomers is less? Means it is due to it is unsymmetrical, means it is not symmetrical. not symmetrical. It is not a symmetrical molecule. Symmetry not there. And it is a symmetrical molecule. It is a symmetrical molecule. Remember, trans showing symmetry. We can make two parts, two equal parts. But here we can't. So, this compound is not symmetrical. This is symmetrical. Symmetrical molecules always having high melting point than non-symmetrical. That is unsymmetrical. Why means, it is very clear, symmetrical molecules having, that is molecules packed into molecules pack in crystal better manner. Pack in crystal better manner due to symmetry. And all molecules will come to close to each other. When close to each other, attractive forces are more. This is the reason. Due to symmetry, molecules pack in crystal better manner. Means they are close to each other. When they are close to each other, attraction is more. More the attraction, what you are getting? Their melting point also high. Attractive forces are more means melting point is high. That more the attractive forces, melting point high. And here what we discussed, molecules not packed better means closeness not there, attraction less means melting point also less. So due to symmetry, trans isomers are having more attraction, means all molecules pack in better manner, attraction is more, melting point is more. Due to unsymmetry, molecules not pack better manner, attractions are very less, lesser the attractions, we can melt easily. So this is the main reason. Melting point depend on the structure. Structure means arrangement. Symmetrical arrangement always high melting point than not symmetrical. That is non-symmetrical. This is very important. So you have to remember this point, very important for competitive. Why? Because if all molecules are very close, density also will increase. Molecules not in better manner, density also affected. Means here density less, here density is more. That property also we'll discuss now. So it is clear now. Dipole moment of cis is more than trans. Melting point of cis is less than trans, because trans isomers are symmetrical and cis isomers are non-symmetrical. Now let me discuss another property, that is density. How density will be affected? Density will be affected. Third property I am discussing, density. So density of cis. So generally, density of cis isomers very low. Density of cis isomers very low. Look here, I am taking the molecule C double bond C. Here four groups we have to attach. And you take COOH. Here one group. And here you take COOH group. And here I am taking hydrogen. And this is hydrogen. And take here a same molecule same molecule, C double bond C, C double bond C, and COOH group here, and in opposite direction COOH group, and here hydrogen, and here hydrogen. So by looking this only, you can identify this is the cis and this is the trans. Now the property of density we have to discuss. And better we go for the name of this acid, malic acid we are calling. What we are calling? Malic acid. This is malic acid. This is a trans malic acid. This is cis. This is cis malic acid. This is trans malic acid. Malic acid. And in previous example I explained that cis are having unsymmetrical. Unsymmetrical means close packing not there. Close packing not there means molecular arrangement is not property. So in proper manner molecules not there. That's why density is low. Density is low. Melting point low means density also low. And here symmetry. Due to symmetrical nature, all molecules having the close packing, then the density also high. So trans molecules, that is isomers, are more denser than cis due to their symmetrical and non-symmetrical arrangement. Next, another property I am going to explain to you. Property, very important property, that is solubility. Number of times asked this property for JEE, you have to concentrate. Solubility. Solubility of cis and trans. Cis and trans. So same molecule I am taking here, same malic acid. According to malic acid only I am explaining. Solubility. This is cis malic acid. And here I am taking trans malic acid. Trans malic acid. Clear? This is hydrogen and this is hydrogen. Cis and trans. Now solubility we have to discuss. Cis isomers have high solubility because of their weak lattice enthalpy. These are having high solubility and these are having low solubility. What is the reason? What the reason I told? Higher solubility because this weakly held. I told reason due to weakly held. Attraction is less na? Less attraction means density is less, melting point also less. That's why solubility more. And here low due to strong or strongly held. All molecules are closely, very strongly held. In melting point I explained. That's why due to strongly held, solubility of trans, solubility of trans malic acid is less when compared cis. Weak forces. Yes, strong forces. Next, another property I am going to explain to you. Another property, that is boiling point. What is the point I am explaining? Boiling point. Already melting point I explained. Melting point for cis is less, trans is more. And this time here I am taking example for boiling point, dichloroethene. This is cis and here I am taking trans. Dichloroethene. Now we have to compare the boiling point of cis and trans. And this is cis, you know very well, same group, same side, same groups in opposite direction. Now boiling point we have to discuss. cis isomers having high boiling point. Cis isomers having high boiling point. Melting point is low, boiling point is high. Trans isomers having low boiling point, high melting point. High melting point. Clear? Y means due to dipole-dipole interaction. Here, due to dipole-dipole interaction. Dipole-dipole interaction. See the two dipoles in same plane. That dipole-dipole interaction is very high. And here also, dipole-dipole interaction is low boiling point. Low boil. These are in opposite direction. That's why boiling point is very less. So boiling point of cis isomers is very high when compared to trans due to dipole-dipole interaction. Here dipole-dipole interaction not there. See, these are now in opposite direction. This is this direction and this is in this direction. And here same direction, same plane, they are in same plane. That's why here high melt, high boiling point and trans are low boiling point. These are five we have. So here dipole interaction not there. Here dipole-dipole interaction is there. These are the five physical properties of cis and trans. So I repeat one more time. You know cis and trans isomers, same groups or atoms or same plane, that is we are calling cis, and same atoms or groups are in opposite plane, trans. Dipole moment of cis is high when compared trans due to dipole moment of polar groups have additive property. This is in the same plane, this dipole moment moving in the same direction. Here in opposite in direction, that's why. Here dipole moment of polar groups opposing, here dipole moment of polar groups are additive, adding. Melting point. Melting point of cis isomers is low when compared trans due to trans isomers here symmetrical structure. When symmetry is there, molecules are packed in crystal in better manner, means close manner. When closeness is there, attraction is more, melting point more. But here melting point of cis isomer in not in symmetrical structure. This is not in symmetry. So when symmetry not there, molecules not packed in better manner, attraction is less, melting point also less. And you go for now density. And density is another important property of cis and trans. Here I took malic acid. And this is cis malic acid, this is trans. See here, they are packed in trans packed better manner. When they are close, all molecules are very close to each other. Generally density is more. If molecules are not close and density is less. Solubility, very important property of isomers. Solubility of cis isomers very high when compared to trans due to here molecules already we discussed that they are weakly held. So when weakly held, they are soluble easily. But in trans, molecules are strongly held. That's why melting point is more. But when strongly, molecules are all together strongly held, their solubility is less. Boiling point of cis isomers is very high when compared trans. Because in cis isomers, dipole-dipole interaction is there. See this dipole-dipole interaction. But here in the opposite direction, dipole-dipole interaction not there. Where dipole-dipole interaction is more, it is showing more energy to boil. And here interaction not there, that's why low boiling point. And same manner, chemical properties also. Chemical properties. What chemical properties also I will give. Cis isomers show different chemical properties. Different chemical properties. Remember, cis isomers show different chemical properties. Cis isomers shows different chemical properties, but trans shows a different from cis. Cis isomers show different chemical properties than trans, and chemical properties of trans are different from cis. So these are showing different chemical properties. These also showing different chemical properties. Different chemical properties. So cis isomers shows different chemical properties than trans. And here chemical properties of trans isomers are different from the cis. So trans isomers properties is different from cis, and cis chemical properties are different from cis. These are showing different chemical properties. Different chemical properties. Like you know, physical properties also different. Same manner, chemical properties also different. And this is about physical and chemical properties. Chemical properties also we have, but that much no need. Just you remember melting point, boiling point, solubility, density, dipole moment. These are very important for competitive concern. Still, if you need anything about cis and trans isomers properties and you go for it in comment, we'll explain in next video. Thank you.